What's up, geeks, and welcome to the channel. In the previous video of the series, we implemented the queue data structure while making use of the built-in stack classes and functionalities in Java. Today, you guessed it, we are going to implement the stack data structure while making use of built-in Java queues. As we did last time, and as a quick reminder, a stack follows what we call a LIFO structure, where the last item pushed to the stack is the first item that is popped from the stack. However, queues follow what we call a FIFO structure, where the first item in queued is the first item to be dequeued from the queue, just like any waiting line at the cinema or a vending machine or a parking machine. With that out of the way, how are we going to take the properties of a queue, manipulate them in a particular way, in order to build a stack? In the last video, when we tried to implement the queue by using stacks, we made use of two of them. Now, what if we could do something similar here? So, let's see what using two queues will look like. And suppose we have the following two queues and this stack partially filled with the same elements. Up until this point, if we want to pop the top element from the first stack represented by the two queues, or pop the same element from the second actual stack, we will have a similar behavior. However, if we are pushing an item to the top of the stack, the behavior will change. As in the first one, the element will be in queued after 4. However, in the second, it will be pushed on top of 6. To fix this and replicate the second stack behavior into the first one, what we can do is add the value of the second queue we have first. Then proceed by emptying all the elements we have in the first queue into the second one right after the item we just added. At this point, we have two choices. We either re-empty all of these elements again from the second queue onto the first one, because what we need is one source of truth at all times. You see, we can't rely once on the first queue to pop the top element or peek at it, and at some other time rely on the second queue to do that, right? Or what we can do is simply switch the references of our queues so that the second queue becomes the first and the first queue becomes the second one. Now, after doing this, if we want to peek at the top element of our stack, we go ahead, retrieve the first queue, and peek at its first element. Okay, to implement our stack class, we will first start by creating two queues. Our target is basically to implement the isEmpty, the peek, the push, and the pop functionalities. As we saw, the content of our stack is ultimately reflected in the first queue at all times. This is our source of truth. So, to check if the stack is empty, all we have to do is check if the first queue is empty. Similarly, to peek at the next element to pop, all we have to do is return the top element of the first queue. Now, we also mentioned that popping an element from the stack has the same exact behavior as dequeuing an element from the head of our first queue. So, to implement this, all we have to do is check. If our first queue is not empty, we remove and return the first element in this queue. Finally, to push an element in the stack represented by the two queues, the first step we need to do is add the element at hand to the second queue we have. Then we have to empty the contents of our first queue into the second queue, as we previously saw. And at last, we swap the references of both our queues so that the pop and peek functionalities work seamlessly and have one source of truth they can rely on at all times. To test our development, I made use of the built-in Java stack functionalities by pushing and popping a few elements from the stack. We can now compare these results to the ones we obtained by using the stack we just implemented. As you can see, the results are similar and our stack behaves exactly as a normal stack would. So, that's it for this video. I hope it was helpful. Thank you guys for watching. Take care and I will see you in the next one.